Conditional formatting can be a major problem when it comes to speed. So just to show you, this file we're about to open has no formulas, no text, basically nothing in it except conditional formatting. So what you'll notice with this is when you open it, it takes unnaturally long to open, even though it's effectively a blank spreadsheet. And you'll notice that, so moving around is not too much of a problem, but if you try and do anything, so for example, I'm going to try insert a row here. So I'm going to say insert. You'll see this takes an unbelievably long time to actually do. So we're going to speed ahead. So that took a long time. To find conditional formatting, couple of ways you can do it. So the one way you can go to Home, Find and Select, go to Special, and here we can say, please show me all the conditional formats, either all of them, or if we knew what was on the cell, we could say same. But for now, I'm just going to say all conditional formats. And when I say OK, you'll see again, it takes a very long time just to find all the conditional formats. And again, we're going to speed ahead. So what you can see is the Go to Special has found all of these cells have conditional formatting on them. If you go keep going to the right, you'll see there's quite a bit. And in fact, this one we've actually reduced the number of conditional formatted cells. This just tells us that there's a problem, and that's probably conditional formatting. Fortunately, there's not too much you can do with this. You could try and go to Home, Conditional Formatting. You can do Clear Rules from Selected Cells. We'll do that just now. But for now, I just want to go to the Manage Rules. And it'll just show you what the potential problem is. And again, if conditional formatting is this slow to open up, it's a good indication that it is the problem. So now that it's actually finished, if you have a look, you'll see that the conditional formatting seems to be very strange, very unoptimized. Cell values, each letter is individually checked, and you'll see it's even struggling to show what it applies to. But so when conditional formatting is poorly optimized, it can cause major lag problems. I'm just going to close this. Now, to get rid of conditional formatting, you need lots of patience. So if you can, the best is to delete entire columns and rows. But if you can't, what we're going to do is we're going to maybe highlight the whole section. If you go to conditional formatting, you'll see there's clear rules. And I'm going to say clear rules either from the selected cells, if you're not sure where it should happen, whilst in this case, I'm going to clear it from the entire spreadsheet. But again, when you click it, you may need patience, and patience may actually involve running the process overnight. Even if Excel says it's not responding, it actually is working. So give it a chance. And finally, it's done. And now you'll see, if we go and I insert a line, again, it's back to normal speed. If your spreadsheet is very slow and it doesn't seem to make sense, this could be one of the reasons. So in this case, the spreadsheet is slow when we do almost anything. So for example, blank spreadsheet, or it looks blank. I'm going to click here. I'm going to type a number. I'm going to push enter. When I push enter, notice I've pushed enter. It took a little bit of time to actually do the enter on a blank spreadsheet. If I format, notice it thinks about it first. So that little bit of slowness indicates that Excel's doing something else. Now we're going to show you, I'm just going to switch the grid lines back on. You may get a clue, so you'll see it's a bit slow. But notice when the grid lines are on, you've got these like shadows. This is something called picture links. Can happen accidentally. the way to find it first, I'm going to go to Home, Find and Select, go to Special, and we look for all the objects. When I click OK, you'll see that all the objects are found, and in this case, it's these things called picture links. If I delete them, and we now go, you'll notice now when I enter, it's instantaneous. There is no waiting. These picture links, they can be useful, but they can cause problems. What they are is if I copy a cell, I come over here, and if I go paste, and next to where there's a picture with a little link, and that's how it happens. That's people get confused and push the wrong one. When I click on it, this is effectively now a picture of whatever's there. So if we go here and we make it yellow, you'll see that turns yellow. So this is watching that. And if you have too many of these, it slows your computer down exponentially. If your spreadsheet is slow when you enter a number, it may indicate this problem, especially where someone has hidden rows and columns so that you don't actually see them. So for example, here's a simple spreadsheet, simple calculation. All it's doing is just adding up the ones above. When I put a 2 in here, instantaneously it calculates. If I ever come here, push 2, I'm going to push enter now, and you'll see I'm waiting. Eventually it calculates. If that is the case, it's not a formatting issue. I can format in full speed. That's not a problem. What you may find is unhide this section. And you'll see that the formulas actually go on. And if you go, you'll see that formula goes all the way to the very last column. So when people hide columns and rows, depending how they do their copies across, sometimes they think they're copying to here, but they actually are copying all the way to the very end of the spreadsheet. And you can see the difference. When I click top here and I click enter, you'll see thinking. Eventually it changes. Whereas if I highlight those, get rid of them. So it takes a bit of time because it's quite a few cells. And now we go and change the number, you'll see it's back to full speed. So watch out for these gray areas where people have hidden the columns or rows. Sometimes there are calculations in there, and if not done correctly, it can slow your spreadsheet down exponentially. If your spreadsheet is slow and it does some strange things, so for example, on the right hand side here, we've got a spreadsheet, we've actually deleted all the contents, we've just left the problem behind. And notice, it's just a little bit slow, and if I highlight a section and then I click on another cell, you'll see it takes a while to actually register that I've asked it to click there. Whereas on a normal spreadsheet, you should be able to highlight, do whatever you want. This may indicate that you've got hidden name ranges. Now just to show you what these are, I'm going to go to Formulas. At the moment, when I go to the name manager, you can see there are very few named ranges. However, there's a macro that you can run, which unhides these name ranges. So I'm going to run it. And when I now go look at the name manager, and you'll see it's a bit slow, you'll see suddenly there's tons and tons of named ranges. And if you look at them, there's references to directories and all sorts of strange things. You need to obviously check if these are important or not, but generally if they're hidden, they probably aren't that important. So I'm just gonna go change the scope. I'm just gonna go to the workbook ones, because in this spreadsheet, that was the problem. Highlight the first one. Go hold my shift key down, highlight the last one, and then delete them. Now that they deleted, also close. And now notice I can highlight a section, and now suddenly I can move around at normal speed. If your spreadsheet is slow only after you open it for a few interactions and then it speeds up to normal speed, it could actually have something to do with your printer. So you'll see here, if I go to my printer, we've made our default printer an onboard printer. So this is actually just a PDF writer. The reason we do that is because if your printer is something that's not connected, say you've got it connected at the office, you go home, you open up, Excel takes a few seconds just to figure out if it can find the printer and if there's anything it needs to know. So our suggestion is, if you click down here and you go to printers and scanners, set your default printer as an onboard printer, something that you always connected to, you'll always have available. Now in Windows, there's a setting over here that says let Windows manage my default printer. So if that's on, it probably should be okay. But if that's not on, or you have to leave it off, you'll notice this one is shown as the default. So the way to make things default, you click on it, you say manage, and you'll see there's a button there set as default. What you'll find is that Excel won't spend the first few seconds of an open spreadsheet checking what the printer settings are.